overeat. Check you. Already reaching apprentice rank. Now that's got us to Folly Wall, the top of the continental shelf. There are massive readings in this area. Something big. Let's carry out another investigation and find out both what it is and how it got here. Perhaps it's our phantom. I'm noticing there aren't as many small schooling fish in the area. The two I've seen are the sea bass and the sardines. Perhaps start with scanning three shoals of the sea bass. Remember, use your abalone mimic for getting their attention. Dan suggests that their community size is rather small. Something's keeping their numbers low. We can only wonder if it's related to the large readings we picked up when we entered this zone. The only other small schooling fish to be worth getting an estimate on would be the sardines. I'm always amazed at how relaxed these guys are. They'll stay pretty chilled, short of you swimming directly through them.
What's this thing? Oh! Oh, ha! Sharp body.
The continental shelf runs right around the perimeter of every single continent, hence the name. They effectively outline the massive plates on which our human civilization sits. Especially considering that schools of sardines can reach up to 7 kilometers in length. I wonder if their new neighbor has taken a shine to them. We need to learn about what's going in at the bottom of the food chain. Quickest way is to lure in a creature that feeds off the seabed. Try seeking out a crab and feeding it an abalone mimic. Abalones. It's not even abalone anyway. In New Zealand, it's power.
What the fuck?
Will you look at all of that? It's so upsetting. The upwelling has brought in all this trash. It's snared at the base of the shelf. Only a hint of what's out there, I'm afraid.
Thank you.
That internal reading from the lure tells a lot about the nutrients in the area. It appears our crab has been dining on remains carried here by upwelling currents. This kind of change in the system might have encouraged different creatures to join us at this depth. Now let's go to the other end of the food chain. What starts off as calcium-rich ooze at one end will work its way up to the bigger predators. So luring a tuna fish would be helpful. Check the mimic selector to find out what they prey on. You've impressed people at the top. Opening up this drone relay so soon after starting with us is not something we've seen for quite a while. Amount of mercury present in that gal. Mercury, of which around 30% comes from man-made sources, can't be excreted. So it simply travels up the food chain and accumulates in top predators such as this tuna. Well, that's before we eat them. Then it accumulates in me and you, hence mercury poisoning. Let's pick up data from the local relay. See if that sheds any light on who could be lurking here. Interesting. There's a wide range alert along the rise. Looks like a scanned whale shark has gone missing thousands of miles south of here. Okay, time to go hunting. Get yourself up and away from the shelf, right out into open water. See what you can see.
I don't like open water. Fally. Alter, was das?
There's our rogue signal. A whale shark. You do not normally see them in this area. I wonder where it's come from. See if you can get a mimic inside him. I reckon your best bet will be a sardine or sea bass. He's a filter feeder, so eats by letting food drift into his mouth. He won't come to you. You'll just have to lay it in his path.
Whoa.
This guy is hungry. He's clearly traveled for some time now and not having a great deal of luck. It looks like he's ended up with quite a few of those plastic bags inside him as well. Interestingly, his readings also suggest that he's used to living in a far colder climate.
Whoa.
All right, you knew this was coming. To complete this investigation, I'm going to want you to get a scan. It might take some ace rig piloting to pull off this one. Best if you avoid touching him. Beautiful. Well done, you. What a beauty. And he's definitely had a track on him at some point. Why so far from home? You've gained access to column 239. Return to the dock when you've seen all you want to see here. Like you found yourself a little cave. Various kinds of tectonic movements can cause these. This doesn't extend into the shelf, which is probably a good thing, as caves can become particularly easy to get lost or trapped inside. Like an old gill net. I'm guessing it was taken down. That's at least good to see, because if it was left, they'd go on catching fish forever.